If your office is anything like ours, you've got people making phone calls, working tickets, having meetings, and just getting stuff done. The last thing that anyone needs to hear is Marty at the end of the hall ranting about van life with a mouthful of burrito.
The towing capacity necessary is really where you're at on the three-quarter ton, because to be honest with you,
that's why we installed a sound masking system when we moved into our office 5 years ago. At the time, we chose to go with Cambridge Sound's QT sound masking system. I'll tell you why just as soon as you smash that like button. Today, we turned the system off for the first time in 5 years so we could make this video. And the difference was startling. Sound masking, or white noise as it's more commonly referred to, is really just low volume background noise tuned to a specific frequency to mask human speech. It's designed to reduce the intelligibility of speech from others in the noise field, and pretty much just sounds like someone turned up the volume on the AC. Think of it like stars at night. They're most visible when it's pitch black. But as dawn approaches, you see them less and less as more ambient light fills the sky. Sound masking works the same way. Ambient conversations and sounds are still there, but it becomes less and less noticeable when the sound masking field is turned up. All right, I'm gonna do a real quick demo of the white noise. I've got Michael out in the hall reading a book, and I'm gonna go ahead and turn the white noise off and on. So here's with the white noise on. I just can no longer hear all the enunciations he's making. I can hear that he's talking out there, but it's not annoying and it's not keeping me from being able to say what I need to say. I don't know how much that's gonna come across on the microphone here, but it's quite stark in the room itself. It just makes it easier for me to concentrate, not be annoyed or distracted by the noise surrounding me. And just a quick sample without me talking.
This perceived truth impacted very little exploration. People feared that if they traveled too far, they might fall off the edge of the ground.
The sound field is accomplished with a grid of emitters in the ceiling. They're not speakers, they're emitters. The emitters have a simple collar and they install right in the ceiling grid. They come in either black or white, and they have other mounting options available for open ceilings. Each of these Cambridge Sound emitters covers about 100 square feet, and they come in packs of four. One of the great things about Cambridge Sound is they'll actually design a layout for your space for a cool $75 if you provide them with a set of plans. The installation is super simple. They just connect in a chain using pre-terminated Cat3 cables, and you can make your own if you need to do custom runs. There's a controller which you can either wall mount or do what we did and rack mount it in the server closet. The system also has a web-based interface to control volume, start and stop times, and a variety of other parameters. The system works really well in large open offices, call centers, and in areas where sensitive conversations are happening, like medical, dental, legal, and financial offices. For me, I kind of forgot the thing was here until we started brainstorming some video ideas. And when we turned it off, the difference was stark. Honestly, I can't wait to finish filming so we can hook the thing back up. But don't just take my word for it. Here's what our employees think.
Did you notice anything different in the office today?
Yeah, it definitely feels a lot quieter.
Yeah, everybody's super loud. They talk and I can hear every single phone ringing or button press now. It's pretty annoying.
Did you notice anything different in the office today?
No.
If you're looking to get a sound masking system for your office, I'll have a link in the description below. If you like this video, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one.
No, what would you need four-wheel drive for? The thing is so dang top heavy that you can't exactly do any like real off-roading. So you're best off to just not try to get stuck in the first place, because four-wheel drive is, you know, obviously beneficial, and maybe it was an all-wheel drive for the sake of driving 50 miles an hour in the snow or something like that, but